Just getting the screen bezel in position now. I tell you what, you just can't believe how tight this goes in. there's not a millimetre to spare. Right? It's a real juggling act. So that's got to go up there, and that just clears that. And that drops down onto my two little stops. And there it is. So I've got two screws at the bottom there that I've fixed it, and just got to now screw it in from the top. And then we can take off the protection and work out where the artwork needs to go. Here we go then. I've got the sheet of plexiglass Perspex all nicely mounted in there. It's quite solid. And when the control panel closes down, time that's got some artwork on it, I think that's looking quite good. So round the back here, just to show you what I did, in case you're doing this yourself, it's actually quite easy. I haven't cleaned it up yet, but you can just see there, look, I just basically drilled through some holes, countersunk them, and goes on there sort of quite nice. Then you can't really sort of see it down the bottom there. So that's it, another bit done. My next job then is I just need to get a sort of permanent marker now and a ruler and just mark around the bezel of the actual TFT display on the monitor. Now, of course, the monitor itself, yeah, is silver. Yeah, it's a bit of a shame. Might have to paint it out black or maybe stick some sort of graphic over that, because that is a bit obvious, isn't it? Now, I don't know if I ever mentioned this right back on one of the very first videos, but make sure when you use a monitor, and this is especially true if you're going to use a CRT monitor, a big old-fashioned one, make sure that you've got a monitor that goes onto standby when you switch the power off and doesn't completely shut down, meaning that you have to push a button to get it to come back on. Quite fortunate, this one always just goes onto standby. As long as you don't press the button, that's fine. If you have got a monitor that goes off immediately, switches off, and I assume some of these power saving monitors have probably got a timer in it that after a while will completely switch off, well, your options, I suppose, are a little limited. If you can get inside it, you can probably jump the switch, possibly. At the very worst, you might just have to drill a very small hole in the bezel there and just have a kind of a pin or something to put it in. Not ideal, but just bear that in mind when you're choosing a monitor. You want one that stays on standby as soon as you took the power on. But anyway, right, I'm gonna finish for today. We'll just have a look at that artwork before I finish this part of the video, and just to see how it goes onto this bit. Now, do you like a bit of Perspex? I just haven't fixed that. That has just gone in absolute friction fit. I will, I think, just put, well, possibly four countersunk holes. Actually, I might not. I've got some aluminium strip to go over that. I think it'll hold it, to be honest. I think it's such a good fit. So, right, we're going to just have a quick look at the graphic there. And Rockstar print graphic, and just sort of hold it up and see how it goes. Now, Sean pointed out something that was quite interesting, which I didn't realise. When he was looking at the graphics before, Sean said that, you know, that vinyl looks quite thick, so we're not quite sure how much light that's going to let through. So I was going to rub this down with sandpaper and diffuse it, but I'm going to hang on for now, and we'll hold the graphic up in a minute, and we'll see how much light comes through, because it might just be that the vinyl itself, which appears to be kind of white and then printed on top, is enough to diffuse them LEDs on its own without you know, actually diffusing the plastic. Well, we'll see. I don't know. We'll do that just in a minute. Right, got the computer booted up. So, got the new graphic here from Rockstar Print, that company on eBay. Haven't opened it up yet. And this is a slightly different design. He actually offered me a slightly different design. Oh, look it out. Check it out. Hey. Oh, look at that. Can you see that? Once again, you know, he's done me proud. That is lovely. The X-Wing fighter and the TIE fighter there. Hopefully it's going to fit. I haven't tried it, obviously. Oh, there you go. This time, look at that. Perfect. Oh, that is perfect. I don't even need to trim that. Look at that. Perfect fit. Absolutely Perfect fit. Right. Very, very happy with that. Thank you, Rockstar Print. I will leave another link, if I remember, in the bottom of the video. But, I mean, £7 delivered. Yeah, come on, guys. You know, £7 for that is dog cheap. You can't even buy the vinyl for that. Right, okay, let's boot up the light. I've got the little sensor there on the inside of the Perspex. I'm hoping this infrared will go through. Yay, check it out. Now then, bearing in mind, I've got the thick cardboard paper on the back. I can't peel that off yet until I'm ready to go on, but it's to give us an idea. Well, that's not bad, is it? I don't know how it looks on camera. Do you know what? That's pretty damn good. Once I've got the backing paper off, that is pretty damn good, isn't it? Already that's... I don't think I'm going to need to diffuse that, to be honest. I could do, I suppose. What do you reckon? It's hard to say, isn't it, without the paper coming off. I don't know how it looks on camera. It's going to be hard to say, but I don't know if I really need to diffuse that Perspex. What can I do? What can I do? Let's get a little bit of this off cut. I don't think I need this. Let's have a look. Let's stick an off cut over. No, I think if you go by that. Oh, check that out. What do you think of that? Zoom in a little bit. That is awesome, isn't it? That really is good. Let's see if I can get the zoom on the camera. Hopefully it will keep focus. Look at that. No, that diffuses quite nicely. I'm not going to do any better. So I can put that transfer straight on. And that's the effect I'm going to get. So I am very, very pleased. I'm like foot in the shed pleased with that. Looking good. So I think that's my next job, is just to mount the transfer. I shall do it wet again like I did on all of the others. I won't bother showing you that because you've seen that process. You wet the plastic down, lay the vinyl out, squeegee out all the water, which gets rid of all of your dust. And then obviously, you know, that will go on perfectly great. Fantastic. Right, I'm going to get on and crack on.
There you go.
That is so wet at the moment. I've got to be so careful with that. It's literally just been laid on wet. But look at it. Check it out. It's fantastic. So excited. It's crazy. I'm so excited about it. The way the actual thing all changes colour. And the LEDs almost look like nebula, don't they, in the background of the star field there. I'm getting so carried away. I'm going to lower the blinds down a little bit. See if I can get it a bit darker. I've got a bit of sun coming in. Let's get it. Check it out. I'm going to also turn the lights out. And there you go. That's with the lights turned out. Just look at it, look. The way the actual Star Wars logo changes colour. That is amazing, isn't it? Absolutely amazing. That looks just like an arcade machine, I think. I mean, you know, I've got to be careful because it's very wet at the moment. I might just have to do a little trim on the end there. But look at that. What a way to end a video. Totally, totally happy with that. And what a great light that Sean made, that marquee light that he made for me there. I mean, how that's worked. So well done, Sean. You can see it now in all its kind of glory. I don't know if you could visualise it like I could, but you can see now how that was going to work. And it hasn't even got little trim bits on it yet. So there you go, guys. I am absolutely made up with that. I am so pleased with that. And I can then, on the next video, I can now crack on and do the bezel artwork and make something up to hide the monitor. Look at that, look. Oh, I just can't stop looking at it. Okay, welcome back. And I know you haven't been away, but for me, this is another day. The last time I left the video, I just briefly put the marquee on the top there. I was very, very impressed how that looked. Over the moon with that, actually. You probably was able to tell. Right, this part of the video is all about now the screen bezel, this other piece of 5mm plexiglass Perspex. Now, I just thought I'd show you how I've managed to fix this. I showed you on the last section that I'd put in 3 screws at the top, which unfortunately has created quite a lot of dust that I've now got to clean off. But on the bottom here, yeah, really, really tight, actually, on the motherboard there. But I don't know if you can make that out. I've just got a couple of very, very small, tiny screws there, just in the corner, just to hold this. And because this is 5mm, it's certainly sort of very, very tough. So, as I say, this part of the video, going to just get a permanent marker and mark round the aperture there of the visible part of the monitor screen. And then we're going to sort of mask this out with, probably going to try and use some of the graphics that I had left over from when I did the sides. Not sure if that's going to work at this stage. There are other things you can do if you haven't got any graphics. Quite a lot of people, they work from the back of the screen and to simply mask out a square and then spray the back with black paint. Yeah, and that does the job actually. From this side, it will look sort of quite professionally done, but I fancy doing it with a little bit of artwork. So that's what I'm going to be getting on with today, and I think I need to crack on with that. So what I've got in mind to create a bezel, like a frieze really, is just to use a few odd pieces of vinyl that I had left over from the sides. I'm not quite sure how well it's going to work at the moment, to be honest. Going to sort of just in Blue Peter fashion, I'm going to make it up as I go along, but I think it'll work. You know, it's probably better than just spray paint. Like I say, I've got a few bits of vinyl to kind of use up, and not entirely sure how it's is going to work. Hopefully I'll try and do it with as little cuts as possible. But that's going to be the idea anyway. I don't know. See how it goes. I think it'll be alright. I think it'll work reasonably well, depending on sort of, you know, how much vinyl I've got. I've got little off cuts here and there. I want it to kind of look reasonably well. You know what I mean? I don't want it to look stupid. Obviously, some of it's going to sort of show. So I've got to play around with that, and hopefully, when I've finished it, it'll come up with something pretty good. If not, well, I said I saw the mistakes, and you'll see another mistake as I peel it all off and end up masking it out and spraying it with black paint. Now, hopefully it won't end up like that. Anyway, let's see how I get on in a second. Now, for the bezel screen with the plexiglass, we can use the same technique as I did with the MDF, and that is to wet down the plastic and the vinyl first. Basically, it's just so you know, you get a second chance on this, because this adhesive vinyl will really, really stick very well to this plastic. So without doing this wet, to be honest, you're going to get literally one attempt at it. But when it is wet, like I've said right from the start, you know, you can line this up and you can move it about if you want to make sure that you get a get exactly pretty much where you want it, which is probably about there, I guess. So, like I say, you know, I'm not quite happy with that. I can go that way actually, so I might find that might be a slightly straighter edge, so I can pick it up, move it around. Yeah, maybe that way. There we go. You can even sort of squidge it about. Got to be patient. It takes a little bit longer for the, obviously, you know, for the water to come out of the vinyl. But it, in my opinion, it's the best way to do it. It just gets all the dust out as well. There we go. So that's the first bit laid. Just got to carry on with that now. This is what I came up with after a little bit of playing around. I don't know yet, it's kind of got to grow on me a little bit, do you know what I mean? Still got a little bit of trimming to do. Use this sort of frieze here, this graphic here, which was a continuation from the control panel graphic, so when that's slotted down, that kind of flows. Not too happy with the way, that's a very sharp line there, isn't it? I wish I could have sort of broken that up a little bit. Stuck on the little TIE fighters there, and I don't know. I think it's better than maybe just black paint, and once it's all sort of set up, it will probably look okay. Yeah, a bit 50-50 at the moment. You know what it's like with your own work. I'm I'm the world's worst critic when it comes to my own work. But anyway, I think using scraps of vinyl, and I think that's probably as good as I'm going to get. So hopefully once it's fitted, It'll look better. Looking at it in the camera viewfinder, it actually looks better than just sort of lying here on the kitchen table. But anyway, there you go. That's what I've done. So we're going to now offer that up and see how it fits. Okay then, back to the barcade machine itself. Now, I don't know how this shows up on camera. What I've done here is I've just stuck some of the leftover vinyl just around the very edge of the screen here, just to sort of try and block out any silver that shows through. Hopefully that will do the trick. Any luck? Not quite sure. We'll soon find out, won't we? Right, okay, the first test fitting of the bezel. Let's see how bad it actually does look. Yeah, I think I've still got lots of air bubbles and things to get out of it, but I think looking at it sort of straight away, actually, I'm going to probably end up losing the TIE fighters there when it slides up underneath. But well, unfortunately, I needed to use that large piece of vinyl there on the top. Now I've got to be so careful when I do this. It's tight. I just don't want to damage any of this vinyl now. And there we go. That's, yeah, unfortunately I thought I would. So yeah, I've just lost. That's a shame. But as I say, I needed to use that strip. Everything else looks a little bit dirty, but looks okay. So let's tuck that down. And there we go. Well, what do you think? That kind of does flow, doesn't it, when you look at that, to be honest. That sort of does flow off of the control panel there. Yeah, I think that kind of works. It's a bit of a sort of a line, isn't it? Just a sort of, you know, stark line. I sort of put the little Death Stars on there just to sort of try and finish it off a little bit. But, well, what do you reckon? Suffering a lot of reflections on it at the moment. Let's see if I can get the camera lower. Just bear with me. There we go. So if that's any, that's any easier. Not really. So unfortunately, a lot of reflections going on, but I don't think that looks too bad, does it? I mean, bearing in mind this is what a bloke's done on a sort of a dining room table. You know, it's growing on me actually. It's definitely starting to grow on me a little bit. So yeah, there you go. Just got to, you know, let this dry now and go around and get the little bits of last little bits of water out. And so some more dodgy DIY skills later. Just got a couple of aluminium finishing strips there, and they're going to be ready to go up either side of the, well, that way round, either side of the marquee, just to sort of hold that little bit of perspex in there with the graphic. So let's get that fitted. Okay, just a few minutes later, and there you go. What do you think of that? I think that finishes up quite nicely, doesn't it? It's only a little bit of old kitchen trim that we had over, a little bit of aluminium trim, or aluminium, if you're watching from the United States, of course. But, yeah, you know, I think that sort of finishes that marquee up quite nice. So overall, I'm very, very pleased with this marquee, especially the way it lights up and everything. And just a little tiny job to do now is just make a small hole and just glue the little sensor in for the remote control to change all of the light sequences and functions. So I better get on and do that. So I'm going to bring this video to its natural close now. Now I'm just catching up on the comments on the last video. I'm about a week behind. But there's a few people that I specifically want to thank. And to start with, Solly for Life and Shondi 12, I hope I've pronounced that right. These guys have come up with a solution for that crappy T-moulding that I didn't like, and they've suggested that I go to Arcade World, which was a supplier I haven't considered, and I'll be checking that out in the week. And yeah, hopefully I'll be ordering in my 10 foot of T-moulding and I can sort of finish the cabinet off. So thanks to those guys, thank you very much. Also another comment, Steve Galley, excuse the pronunciation again. And Steve says, oh God, you know, it's such a shame that this series is coming to an end. And yeah, it is coming to an end. I've got lots of sort of boring sort of finishing up things to do on the cabinet, which I'll show you anyway, because I am going to show you this right to the completion. But yeah, unfortunately, this one is coming to the end. It's been, you know, so far it's been a great series. I've really enjoyed putting this together. In the future, I do fancy doing a little smaller kind of mini arcade unit, you know, one of these sort of ones that work currently on a Raspberry Pi 2. Time I get round to doing it'll probably be a Raspberry Pi 5. But just a little mini one with a 10-inch or 7-inch monitor, something like that. So yeah, in the future, you know, I might be coming back and doing another cabinet. But I've got lots of other things to do for the summer. You know, I want to get the radios, my radio set up properly. I want to build a radio console up in the attic and things like that. So there'll be other things coming up on the channel. The regular subscribers, the radio guys, Tom, who's normally always first to make a comment, Sean, of course, and Gary and Lewis and everyone else that generally comes onto my channel makes a comment. Thank you. I appreciate every one of your comments. Please remember to give the old videos a thumbs up because that is also regularly appreciated. And yeah, just thanks for watching them. You know, I enjoy making the videos and you know, you guys carry on watching them and I'll still keep turning out this rubbish, all right? Anyway, I'd like to wish you all have a safe week, have a good week, and I'll catch you all on the next one. Fred in the Shed, I'm gone for now.